I will smack you around my garden.
Smells like morning, huh? It is morning. It's 8 a.m. I have my shovel, I have my cup of coffee, and I have my gardening partner right here, and it's a really good day. I wanted to show you my compost pile because that goes with what I'm going to talk about next. The compost that I make every single year is the fuel that feeds the engine, and the engine that runs my garden is the soil. The soil is the most important thing. I don't focus so much on the plants. I focus on the soil because if I take good care of the soil will take good care of the plants. And that is how I garden. That is my whole method of gardening, whether it's indoor gardening or outdoor gardening. All this is here, and this is a very simple mix. This is nothing but leaves that I raked up in the fall, whole leaves out of my yard, because I have all kinds of trees out here. I have walnut, I have elm, I have pines, I have, I don't know. I don't know what these things are. Some of these, I have no idea what they are, but I rake up all the leaves, throw them in the chicken coop. And I've shown it on a previous video that the leaves actually get really thick, about a foot thick of dried leaves. And I toss them in there and the chickens have a good old time. They rake them around, they stomp on them, they play in them, they roll around and dust bath in them, and they also poop in it. And that poop mixed, look at me go, that poop mixed with the leaves I rake out in the spring, and it's dry as a bone, real dusty and stuff. So I lay it out really thin, and I have a 35 gallon trash can that I save coffee grounds in from last year up until now. And I had a full trash can full of coffee grounds and coffee filters. Coffee filters can compost down really nicely too. And I drag that out here and I dump that in. I also dig around and I find anything else in my house that can be composted. I dug in the freezer and I had a 1 gallon bag of bananas that I was gonna use for banana bread. And I had so many bananas, I just really couldn't use them all. So I threw one of those in here too. And basically anything that I could think of to throw in here, I took the hose, I moistened it really good, piled it up. And the trick with making compost is you wanna make sure that you pile this up as tall as it can get without falling over. Just keep piling it up and piling it up. And you just wait and it starts heating up. There is no specific recipe that I use. There is no specific procedure I use. I'm very low tech when it comes to gardening, and I'm very low tech when it comes to my compost, and it seems to work just fine. And this heats up, and I shoved my hand in here and it is warm. It's not steaming yet, but it is warm, and that's good enough for me. And what the compost does is it provides the texture for the soil. If you have really, really thick soil, it'll help your soil be not quite so thick. If you have really light soil, it brings it together. It is the great equalizer in a garden. And it also feeds all of the micro organisms that live in your garden. It feeds the worms. It attracts worms like a magnet, like you would not believe. And all of these things come together to feed your plants. So when you see the plants growing in my raised beds and you wonder how some of them could look so beautiful and so healthy, I'm very flattered, by the way, by the compliment. The reason that my plants look so good is because of this one thing. That is it. I don't use specific anything in my gardening. All I use is compost. So I'm always talking about it. I'm always making it because it makes your soil into something that you just cannot duplicate with chemicals. You cannot duplicate with anything else, with any kind of addition. Compost is the most wonderful thing, the most natural thing that you can put into your garden to help your plants do their best. Now take a look at what my soil looks like in my garden. Rascal. This is my raised bed soil, and I have had them for about a couple years now. And this is the first time I've dug into this. Look at this. This is nice and light and fluffy, and it's just beautiful soil. Of course there's worms in it, but you can see old decomposing and decomposed leaves, little pieces of stick, another worm, a weed seed, ooh, or a vegetable seed, who knows in my garden. There's a peanut shell. There's all kinds of fun stuff in this soil. And the thing is that the compost is what made this soil as beautiful as it is. Worms do not come into really crappy soil. They don't want to go in there because there's nothing to eat. You know, you wouldn't want to go into a place that's really inhospitable to you. But if you put in the compost, the worms will come. And also, look at this soil. Is that beautiful or what? great crumbly soil, and the texture is going to get better and better every single year that I put compost in here. Nice and dark, beautiful. It soaks up enough water for the, ooh, soaks up sticks too. It'll soak up the water just beautifully and drain nicely. See, roots from last year, they eventually decompose in here. Ooh, they even sprout if you leave them in. Last fall, I piled in all kinds of leaves to help insulate my raised beds to keep them from freezing too bad. And the reason I did that is because I want the soil to be a little bit less froze solid, and it will keep the worms in my soil. Now, what I do in the spring is I rake these leaves out and I toss them into the compost pile because they're wonderful and they break down really, really good. The worms have been munching on these in the fall, and I pull these aside and take a look at what I have. Yep, asparagus coming up nice and thick. By the way, these were planted a year ago by seed upstairs in the grow room. So these are only 1 year old. Generally with 1 year old plants, you do not get stems this thick. Usually they come out like really paper thin the first year because they're just barely getting established. I put in all kinds of compost in here because asparagus loves compost. You can never put in too much. They are just heavy feeders like you would not believe, just like corn. So I put in the most compost I possibly could, and I was really limited the year that I planted these, but I put in a ton of them underneath the roots, and each year I put a layer of them in these beds. Now the roots, when I was planting something yesterday, I noticed the roots, when they started out, they were about this wide. Now they're going out about 2 feet all the way to the edge because I was digging to plant some lettuce in here, and I ran into a root and I thought, oops, crap. And so I covered it up really quick. Asparagus roots will go out probably about a couple feet from the initial crown. So make sure you give them plenty of room to grow. And I wanted to show you this because not only am I getting asparagus, I have an idea and I've used this before, and it may help you if you're growing asparagus and lettuce. In this bed, which is 2 feet wide by 10 feet long, every couple of feet I have a crown of asparagus roots, and they're coming up really fast. What I've done is I planted lettuce right here and then right here between the asparagus plants over to the side. I don't want to plant them right in between them because the roots from these plants go over to here. So right over here I planted them, and then also on the other side. What I like to do is I plant the lettuce in with the asparagus because the asparagus will grow up, get really bushy. If you've ever grown asparagus, it gets really, really bushy, and it shades the entire patch. And shading will help keep your lettuce from bolting. So during the heat of the summer, when everything's going crazy and everybody's lettuce was bolting, and in one garden that I had growing up north, I had lettuce growing in with my asparagus and it didn't bolt. I had lettuce going all the way up until August, which is an extremely late month and an extremely hot month of the year in Minnesota. And I was picking fresh lettuce out of my asparagus bed. So if you have an asparagus bed, plant lettuce or spinach or other cool weather shade loving crops in with it, and you're gonna have a lot longer harvest in your asparagus bed, and it doesn't interfere with your asparagus plants. The strawberry bed is coming back to life, and it does have some weeds in here, but I really don't care because eventually the strawberries will get so thick they smother out anything in here. They even smother themselves out. They are nuts. Last fall, I let the plants just die down and left them in here. And then in the spring, you can see a few dead stems, but what happens is the dead stems and leaves eventually break down. They get soft, they get smothered by the plants, and the moisture, the humidity, and the matting will help rot these leaves down, and it attracts worms. So there never is a need to clean out your strawberry bed. You don't have to pull these leaves out, just leave them down there. It helps feed the soil. As far as weeding, if you want to pull out a few weeds, you can. For me, it's just low impact gardening for me. Once I plant my strawberries, I just let them do what they're gonna do. It looks a little sparse here, but that's how it's supposed to look in the spring. As this goes throughout the season, it's gonna get thicker and thicker and thicker. And that's exactly what I wanna do. To keep the birds out, I'm gonna put some fine mesh fencing on top of this bed. And that way it'll let the sun in, but it'll keep the squirrels out and the birds out. And that's definitely what I need to do around here. I have a lot of robins, and robins love fresh strawberries. Smells like dirt, huh? I swear that dog is into smells every bit as much as I am. Only I don't roll around in anything that I find on the ground. I have a little bit more class than that. Not much, but just a little. Is it time to go in? Probably not. We're gonna sit out here for a little bit longer. But I did want you to come out and see the compost pile, see the initial growth in the beds with my asparagus. I'm very excited about that. Strawberries, look at the soil. Yesterday when I was turning over all the raised beds for the first time, I noticed so many worms in there. I felt really bad. I'm digging up and a couple times I killed the worms and I felt really bad about that. But what can you do? I have so many worms in my soil. I'm very lucky. I'm very lucky, and the reason I have so many worms is the compost. The compost is definitely the fuel for the garden, and I keep saying that, but it's true. It is true. People ask me, Ray, what's your secret? You do really good at this. You do really good at that. It's not really me. It's the compost, and the compost feeds the microorganisms in the soil. It feeds the fungus in the soil. It feeds the worms in the soil, and the soil is what makes the plants do what they do. I'm just along for the ride. I'm just the caretaker, and the compost is really definitely what does it for my garden. So I definitely urge you, if you can make compost, do it. If you can buy compost, do that as well. That will definitely help your garden do the best that it can possibly do. And I'm in the middle of hardening off my plants, which means I'm just getting them ready to be brought outside. And I think I'll be planting in the garden in about a week or so. So I'm gonna have you out here with me. Yeah, I know. I drag you everywhere I go, but I'm going to have you out here with me so that we can plant the tomatoes, the peppers, all that fun stuff, and get the garden into full gear. But for right, thanks everybody for joining me in the garden. I really do appreciate it. Have a great day. Bye. You're staring at me. Let's go.